Good day, learners. Today we are going to study this way of trinomials. So for this one, I have three trinomials and we are going to square them. This one is 8 plus b plus c times 8 plus b plus c. So before we proceed to the shortcut, we'll have first the conventional way of solving this one by... I'm going to use the box method here, class. So I have here the first A, B, C. A, B, and C. Nothing. And then times A, B, and C. So let me show you how we multiply this one. So we have A times A is A square. 1 plus 1 is 2. Then after this one, we have A times B, which is positive AB. Then the C. A times C is AC. Okay, we're done with the A. Now let's check the B. B times A is BA or AB. So AB here. After this one, let's have this one. B times B is B squared. Here, no, don't put here. Is it no? So have an empty slot here, a vacant slot here. So we put here the B squared. Let's put the B and the B. And next, we have B times C is BC. No. Then we put here the BC. Okay, next, the C. We have C times A is CA or AC. Let's find some AC here. Oh, the AC is here. So we're going to put here. You want to put here? It's okay. But I'm going to put here, so we know that the C and the A here. So I'm going to put A, C here, but you can put here. Okay, after the A, let's have the B. C times B is CB or BC. So let's find some BC here. And the BC is here, so I'm going to put here the BC. After B, then we have the C and the C. C times C is C squared. So we have put here, no. So I'm going to put here C squared. It's the last slot. Then we add terms. So we have A squared. So we have A squared. Then we have A squared. Okay. And then AB plus AB is, we add the 1 here and the 1 here, so we have plus 2AB. So we have plus 2AB. Now take note class of the 2, and this will always appear in our formula there, 2 times. Just like in our square of binomial, we have always the 2. And here, if we are going to add this one, 1AC plus 1AC is 2AC, and that is positive. So we have plus 2AC. Now you see, we have another 2 here. It is always appearing in our answer. And the B squared. Let us put plus B squared here. What about the BC? Better to add them because I like terms. 1BC plus 1BC equals 2BC. Now you see, we have another 2 again there. And then the last one is plus C squared. And that is our final answer. It's like this. The first start here. 8 times A is A squared. So where is that one here? Here. B. Whether this one is positive or negative, if you multiply it, because we are going to square it, it will always be positive. If you have negative b times negative b, it will be positive b squared. In this case, we have b times b is b squared. This is always plus b squared. We square the second term. Then we square the third term or the last term. And this one, whether this one is positive or negative, our answer there will be positive. Plus, square this one, c times c is c is squared. Now, let's have this 2ab to ac and 2bc. Okay, let's have this one first. Positive and positive plus is positive. So, and put the 2. Always put the 2 there. And multiply this 2, a times b. So you have a. After this one plus, you can have this a and c. Okay? So you have positive again, times positive here is positive there. Now what do we do next? We put again the 2, 2 times a here and then the c. And then next is the B and the C. A, B, A, C, B, C. So the B, C there. So for the B, C, that's positive, and then positive, don't forget again to multiply it by 2. And then we have B times C is B, C. So how many terms do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we have 6 here. They are all the same. Can you still see me here? A. Square it. So we have A is squared. Square this one. Negative B times negative B is positive. B times B. So we have B is squared. Square the third term. Positive. C times C, C squared. Okay, let's have the distributive. 3 times. 1, 2, and 3. So we have this one. Look at the sign now. We're not going to memorize the formula. Positive here times negative here is negative. Then don't forget to multiply it by 2. It's 2. So 2 times A and B. So we have A, B. Next is this one. Or you may prefer this one if you want. I'm going to put that one there. Positive times positive is positive. Don't forget to multiply it by 2. A times C. So we have A, C. The last one is this and this. Negative times positive is negative. Don't forget to multiply it by 2. And then B times C. So we have B, C. That's for number 2. Alright, number 3. Now look at that case. I'm going to put here again. So, for example, we have A minus B minus C. And then we square it. Let's have the square of the first term. So we have a times a squared. Square the second term. So negative times negative, positive. B times b, b is squared. Square the last term. Still positive. Negative times negative is positive. C times c is squared. Okay, let's have the 1, 2, the 3 distributive property. So, A and B. Look at the sign first. Positive times negative, it's negative. And then put the 2. a times b. Okay. Next is this one. Okay. Positive times negative, it's negative. Don't forget the 2. And a times c. So we have a c. Plus the third distributive is this one. Negative times negative is positive. Don't forget the 2. And then b times c is bc. Okay. So we have the 3 possible square of trinomials. Now let us apply that one in our square of binomial. So for the square of binomial, it will be very easy for you now. What's the example of square of binomial? Let's have the minus. Minus b is squared. This one is binomial, this one is binomial. We're not going to have any more the plus because the answer will be all positive or plus. So minus. We square this. A times A is A is squared. We square the second one. Is negative B times negative B is positive. B times B is B squared. And the middle term is this one. Positive times negative is negative. And don't forget the 2. Right? Just like the square of trinomial. And then you multiply A times B. A, B. Now, if you allegorize the plan here, A is squared with this one in the middle, minus 2, A, B, and this is always plus. That's why it's a perfect square trinomial. The sign of the last term is always plus. And then you put the B is squared. We have x squared plus 4x minus 5 times x squared plus 4x minus 5. So we have a squared. What do we do with the first term? We square it. So here, this is the first term. X is squared. 2 is there. What are we going to do with the first term? We square it. Okay? I'm going to square this. That's 2. And this one is inside. Right? This one is plus. And then we square the second term. 4x square it also. We have 3 terms to square. And then we have the 5 here, and we are going to square it also. Next is this one and the second term, distributive now. Plus, because this one is positive, positive is plus. Don't forget to put the 2. And put the x squared now, and put the 4x. Okay. Next is this one. Positive times negative. Can I put here plus? Alright, minus 2 again. And then we put this x squared here, and the 5 there. Alright? And then here, the last distributive, positive times negative, negative. And then don't forget the 2 again. Right? The 4, x, and the 5. Okay. And then we raise it to the 7th power, and then we multiply it to. Let's have this one. X squared times x squared. What do we do with exponents? We multiply the exponents. 2 times 2 is 4. If you do not want that one, we have x squared times x squared. We add exponent, and that is x to the 4. Plus, and the plus here, square the 4x. 4x times 4x, start with a 4. 4 times 4, 16. X times x, x squared here. Plus 25. And then let's say this one, positive or plus 2 times 1, 2 times 4 is 8. X squared times x to the first, 2 plus 1 is x cubed. And then minus this one, minus 2 times 5 is 10, and then copy the x squared, minus 2 times 4, 8 times 5 is 40x. Alright, look here and look for like terms. X to the 4, only one. X squared, oh, we have 2x squared. This one and this one. So we are going to add them. 25, none. X cubed, none. X, none. So we have only one like, one pair of like terms here. This is x and then x. So let's write this one. X to the fourth followed by cube, right? That one, x cubed. So plus, you can do all now. Plus 8x cubed followed by the descending order, x squared. So here and here. Positive, negative, subtract 16 minus 10 is 6. Positive. So positive 6. X squared, and then followed by x. Where's the x now? There, minus 40x, and then last is the number, last 25, and this is our answer. Let's have number 2 class. We have 2x squared minus 3x minus 4 raised to the second power. So let's have the first term here. Square it. Square this. Square that. And then we have the three distributive property of multiplication. Square. 2 times 2 is 4. X squared times x squared is x to the fourth. Okay. Square this one. Plus 3x times 3x. 3 times 3 is 9. X times x is x squared. Square the last term. Plus 4 times 4, 16. Okay, let's have the distributive. This and this. Sign first. This one is positive and this one is negative. The sign is negative. 2 times 2, 4 times 3 is 12. So you write here 12. And then, that's it. We have x squared times x to the first. We have x cubed. After this one, and that one. Sign first. Positive times negative, it's negative. And then 2 times 2 is 4. Times 4 is 16. So we have 16 here. And then x squared, 9. So we have x squared. After that one, this 2. Negative times negative is positive. Again, let's forget the 2. 2 times 3 is 6. Times 4 is 24. We have still an x here, so we put the x there. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Always count your terms. Maybe it will mean missing one and that will be incorrect already. Okay. Okay, let's find some like terms here. X to the fourth, only one. So 4x to the fourth. X to the fourth is followed by x cubed in a descending order. Where's the x cubed? Do we have another x cubed here? None. So we have minus 12 x cubed. X cubed is followed by x squared. So we have here and we have there. So minus 16 and 9, I should have the sign is minus because 16 is greater than 9. And then 16 minus 9 is 7. Right? 9 plus 7 is 16. And then copy the x squared. X squared followed by x. And that one is x. So plus 24. And x is followed by a number. Where's the number here? The plus 16. And that is our answer for number 2. Okay, let's have number 3. So here plus, we have trinomial again. And then we are going to square it. Let's have first term, second term, and the third term. We're going to square this one, square this one, square this one, and then the distributive. 3 distributive. Let's have this one. Square this one. X squared times x squared is x to the fourth. Second term plus 2y times 2y. Start with the 2. 2 times 2 is 4. Y times y is y squared. We square the last term. Plus again. 3 times 3 is 9. Z squared times z squared is z to the fourth. So those are the square of the three terms. All plus. Now let's have this one and this one. Anyway, we don't have problems with the signs because they are all positive. So everything here will be positive. Plus 2. Don't forget the 2. 2 times 2 is 4. And then copy x squared and the y. Next is this one and this one. Plus 2 again. 2 times 3 is 6. So we have 6. X squared, okay. And the z squared. And then after this, we are through with this one. We are through with this one. Last one is this one. I'm going to write like this. Alright, this is still positive. 2 again, don't forget. 2 times 2, 4. 4 times 3 is 12. Y, Z is squared.